First is that I watch my dear friend, Governor Rucha, saying that 5 million members have left. I didn't know he was such a wonderful statistician. Now, the entire membership of the party in Imo State, as far as I know, they are under 1 million, to put it generously. So where the people are coming from, if people have left us because we are not able to help him to create a political dynasty, then it would be nice for him to give further details about the origin, the location of those people who have left. You could see someone on the one hand wanting to run down his party, on the other hand claiming to be loyal to that party. But the truth is that Nigerians have become more and more sophisticated. At the heart of this challenge is the trauma of going through change. You know, if you know of any addict, like, let me say, people who are addicted to alcohol or to drugs, as an example, there is what you call withdrawal syndrome. When you diagnose it and you try to stop them from that way of life that they have been addicted to. Now, unfortunately, and I'm sure you media people will readily agree, most Nigerians have worried that how can we have a democracy in which only few kingpins dominate, and that party membership doesn't carry any meaning, and it is so-called godfathers that anoint. You hear of anointment, you hear of godfather in position. Now, my task has been to consciously work to steer APC away from this very ruinous past which PDP created. You know, to open it up so that it can be membership driven. Now, those who have survived so far, courtesy of this kind of impunity in position, creating dynasty from their own privileged position, to accept the logic of participatory democracy, of bottom-up approach, because nothing explains the frustration of these few people, very few, than the fact that they cannot understand how, in a primary, whether direct or indirect, that the vote of a governor is only one, and the vote of a sweeper of the governor's office, or Alakara, who is a member of APC, is also one. They can't reconcile with them with this reality. So if you have 200 Alakara, 300 sweepers voting for a candidate, and you have one governor, two commissioners, five special advisors voting for another, the logic of our own preferred democracy is that this army of sweepers will defeat these powerful governors. Some are unable to accept this ultimate logic of people-driven, people-based democracy. And what I have simply refused to do is to insist that having cautiously to change as our slogan, that change must begin with us. It must be reflected in what we do, how we do it, and we should learn, however frustrating, to reconcile ourselves with the reality that we are in a democracy. A competent court. He got some traditional rulers. The most prominent traditional rulers in Ogun State are well known. People like the Awujale of Ijebu, and so all those ones refused to attend. But he got some to attend, to come to Abuja, to persuade Abuja to put pressure on me to revise what has been properly done and to accept what is clearly unlawful. Not only unlawful, undemocratic, immoral, and tantamount to abuse of power. Our constitution does not recognize emperors. There are no emperors in APC. If anybody tried to invent himself as one, it would be an exercise in futility. Certainly, with all sense of modesty, not under my leadership. I am clear about our rules, and I'm clear about power, and I'm clear about the limitations of those power. Based on the rules of our party, and in accordance with INEC guidelines, we have since conducted governorship elections in Ogun State, And we have submitted the name of the winner, Prince Dapo Abiodun, to INEC for the purpose of the forthcoming governorship election. That for me has concluded that matter. It cannot be reopened except if a court of competent jurisdiction finds reasons to void what I believe we have done in accordance with the provisions of the law. It is beyond me now or anyone in the NWC to reopen what clearly is legally and appropriately and democratically closed. Yesterday, I also watched on television. This time issued by the Chief Judge of Imo State. I emphasize Imo State, where Governor Richards heads the executive branch, and the judge heads the legislative branch. The judicial branch. That judge, in his wisdom, having heard prayers by those who appear before him, including the sitting deputy governor to Richards, Okorocha, he is the one who went to obtain that order. That order directs me not to have anything to do with any so-called secondary or repeat primary, governorship primaries in Imo State. And so, in line with the advice of my very dear friend, Governor Richards Okorocha, we will have nothing to do with the so-called second governorship primaries that allegedly produced Richards Okorocha's son-in-law, Mr. Uche Nwosu. And for this attack, Governor Richards, for such a wonderful advice. And I hereby accept it in toto, in full, and in good faith. The other one is the issue in alleging that I disobey court order and that I should obey court order. It's a useful advice, except that he was talking to, to the converted. Richards Okorocha, Governor Richards Okorocha, the chairman of Progressive Governors Forum, is a beneficiary of that process. We followed those due process to rescue him, because in this country, memories tend to fade very fast. The congresses conducted by my predecessor completely swept Governor Okorocha out of the system, from ward to local government and to the state. But he raised issues of fairness, of abuse of the process. NWC reflected on it, and I am happy that we find courage to review what was wrongly done, and we subsequently conducted another election, which has now given him teeth to bite and lips to smile. And I'm happy for him. What I am not able to do for Governor Okorocha is to assist him with the instrument of APC, even as that would border on abuse of power on my side, assuming I have such powers, to help him to create Richards Okorocha's political dynasty in Imo State, in which Richards would be the APC senatorial candidate, and Richards' son-in-law, Uche Nwosu, you all seem to know the name, would be the APC candidate. I do not have the power to help him to create a political dynasty in Imo State. I am convinced, and this is where many of my friend governors tend not to understand me, if there is conflict between the known interests of the great people of Imo State, who had reposed confidence in us by voting us to power as they did in 2015, I will resist every pressure, particularly an unlawful pressure on my part to assist to undermine the wishes of the good people of Imo State at this stage, the wishes of APC members in Imo State who do not want a political dynasty by the way in which they have voted. We conducted the first governorship congress, governorship primaries, that was headed by Mr. Gulak. NWC has met. We have reviewed the report of the Gulak committee, and NWC has upheld the result of the Gulak committee because we found that it was in substantial compliance with the guidelines guiding the conduct of gubernatorial primaries that it was mandated to do. And we have upheld it, and we have done the needful by also ensuring that we submit the name of the winner, Senator Hope Uzodinma, as the APC candidate for Imo State. If Governor Rocha chooses to relocate to the villa and use the ground of the villa to try to intimidate me to create a dynasty, I will, even on one leg, but powered by truth and conscience, uphold the best interests of APC members and indeed of APC people in Imo State. I have also advised him, and I need to now say this, that we as a party, just like we respect the rule of law, we also respect our religious leaders. And so Rocha's personal battle with the Christian community in Imo State is a matter between him and the Catholic Church and all the Christian community. We as APC, we are not a party to that. And we do not want our party to be dragged into such contestation because it will be unhelpful to us. We are a party of the people. Our route to power is election by the people. We cannot antagonize the people. Even the ordinary man in Imo is entitled to respect, not to talk of the leaders of the Christian community. And so we distance ourselves from all of those things that Governor Richards has done, which sometimes has been a source of huge embarrassment to our party, but we have tried to manage in-house. Yesterday he said I should obey law. I stand here to say I am obeying laws in full, including laws of our party. He obtained what obviously was an unhelpful expertise, searching for protection. But when you build something on a quicksand, it doesn't stand. That temporary order has since expired, and the judge that issued it has since transferred the case to another judge. You do not have to be a seasoned legal practitioner to understand that ex parte order has limited lifespan. It is not an interlocutory order, nor is it a judgment. And if that is what is parading, then he will need superior instrument to be able to help him sustain his political dynasty, which I am not able to help to build. Yesterday, I also watched your television, and we have since received a document